Hey, everybody. Today's story is one that Jesus told his followers so that they would understand better something very important. It is another parable. And remember, a parable is an earthly story with a heavenly meaning. Today, we're actually going to get Gabriel back.
Hi,
so everybody,
everybody
give Gabriel a hand. He's going to be our singer today, and he's going to help us sing through the story. So Jesus' parable was about a man who went on a journey. And before he left, he gave his servants some money, some things he wanted them to be responsible for. So let's get Gabriel up here. And do you know any songs about road trips?
Road trips? I think I can think of something. Hold on.
Okay. Well, while he's getting ready, this is Gabriel. Let's see what he has to do with road trips.
Heading down the road. Pretty soon I'll be headed down the road. I'm going on a trip and I'll be back, you know. Yeah, I can't wait to be heading down the road. Heading down the road. Yes, indeed, I'm headed down the road. Keep my money safe, can I let you borrow? Cause I'm about to head down the road.
Good job, Gabriel. All right. The man asked his servants to take care of his gold while he was gone. It was their responsibility to take care of what he owned. The man gave 5 bags of gold to one servant, 2 bags of gold to another, and 1 bag of gold to the last. Then he left. Now, what do you think happened when the man went away? Do you think the 3 servants made the most of what they had been given? I'll tell you what, let's find out. This is from Matthew 25, verses 16 through 18. The man who had received the 5 bags of gold went on at once and put his money to work and gained 5 more. So now he's got 10. So also the one with 2 bags of gold went and gained 2 more. But the man who had received 1 bag, he went off and dug a hole and put in the ground his master's money. So the last guy didn't really make the wise choice. He did not take good care of the boss's money. The other ones, you know, they had been able to double the money while he was gone, but this guy, he just went off and buried it. So maybe his song would go something like this.
On sand dunes, high in desert tonight, my boss has gone to Rome. He gave me some gold to treasure, and at some point, he'll be home. The sand is swirling like the fear I feel inside. What can I do? Maybe I'll hide. Don't spend it here, don't give cash there. My boss wants me to do my share. He trusted me to make it grow. But I don't know. Dig a hole, I'll bury it like a mole. Dig a hole, drop it in, then take a stroll. Care when he's going to say when he comes back home. His gold is the same as he left that day. Thank you.
All right, a little go dig a hole instead of let it go. So finally, the master came back and he called his servants together to see what they had done with the things they had been given. And the first came and he showed that he had turned his 5 into 10. And the master was very pleased. And he said these words, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. So then the second servant came, and he had also doubled from 2 to 4 what the boss had given him. So the boss again said these words, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will put you in charge over many things." So that leaves our last servant, the one who didn't make any money, that just buried his gold in the ground. The servant tried to explain his actions. I wonder what that might have sounded like as a song.
It might seem silly what I'm about to say. I have what you gave me when you left that day. I was scared to lose it, so I hid it away. Here's my bag, it's been underground, hidden in the clay.
Because he's lazy.
Sing the song if you feel like a man here is aloof.
Because he's lazy.
Sing the song if you feel like laziness is for fools.
Because he's lazy.
Sing the song if you know that laziness isn't cool.
Because he's lazy.
Sing the song if you feel like that's what you shouldn't do.
The servant had tried to give some excuses for what he had done, but the fact is he had not been responsible. The boss had expected him to make his money grow, but instead he hid the money. He sent the servant outside, he took the servant's bag of gold, and he gave it to the one who had 10. So, can we give Gabriel a hand? All right, Gabriel, good job.
Thanks, everybody.
The boss in Jesus' story gave each of his servants a gift, and he expected them to be responsible for it. It didn't matter how much or how little each one of them got. What mattered is what they did with what they were given. We need to remember that today. In fact, it's a great rule for life. We need to make the most of what God has given us. And here's our bottom line for this week. Make the most of what you've been given. Think about all the things that God has given you. Maybe he's given you a talent, like you're a good artist or good at sports. Maybe he's given you friends and family who love you, and every day you can choose how to treat them. And in every situation, we should be making the most of what we've been given. Remember, make the most of what you've been given.